So now let's start our means proof. So what is the diagram given? Diagram is the basic thing in this. So in our diagram we are given that A B C D is a quadrilateral. Okay, this is a quadrilateral where this side and this side are same, as well as this side parallel to this side. So what we can write in our given section? So in the given section we can write that given, then in the given what we can write? In the given we can write that A B C D given parallelogram. Okay, A B C D given parallelogram, then comma, what else is it given? A B equals to BC, length of AB equals to BC, as well as AB parallels BC. Okay, so AB parallel DC and AB equals to DC, this thing is given. So what is to be proved? So to prove is what? To prove is that AD means this side parallels to BC, that side. So AB AD parallels to BC, this thing we have to prove. So let's start our proof. Okay, so let's start our proof. So how to do the proof? So at first, before doing the proof, we will do the construction. So let's write construction. So construction is required in this sum or in this proof. So what is the construction? Our construction is join BD. So we have to join this BD. Okay, so we have to join this BD, and in the construction part we have to write that join BD. Okay, join BD. We are writing this. Then in the section of to prove, what we can write? We can write that in triangle, again in triangle BAD, in triangle BAD and triangle BCD, and triangle BCD. What are the things that are given? We are writing now. We will write BD equals to BD. So in the bracket, we are going to write that BD is common side of both, and so BD is common side. So we will write BD common side. Then what else is given? AB equals to DC, this is given. AB equals to DC, it is given. So in the bracket we are going to write given. Okay, so AB equals to DC, this is given, and then AB parallel DC, this thing is also given. So one thing let me tell you, if here this type of thing is given, we cannot write that AB parallel DC here. What we can write? We can write this. See, as we can know, there is one formula or there is one theorem that AB, if AB and DC is parallel and BD is transversal. So what is the theorem? Transversal angles are always same. So transversal opposite angles means this angle and this angle will be same. So let's mark it bold, that this angle and this angle are same. Okay. So now I have marked it. So let us write here. So let's write here that angle ABD equals to angle BDC. Angle BDC. Angle ABD, angle ABD, this angle equals to angle BDC, angle BDC, this angle. Okay. So in the bracket, we are going to write, follow the steps. It is a very important thing what we have to write. We have to write that as AB parallel BC, then comma, BD transversal. BD transversal. So BD is transversal. Then what we can write? Then we can write transversal opposite angles are same. Then in the bracket, transversal opposite angles are same. Okay, so transversal opposite angles are same, this thing. So here, what we can say that this is side and this is angle. So side, angle, side. We can write triangle BAD congruence to triangle BCD. Okay, so in the bracket what we are going to write, SA is congruency. SA is congruency. So our proof is not here finished. So let me write it here. Our next step, as it is, it has been proved that it is congruent, then what to prove? We have to prove that. Now this is the very important point we have to note, that this angle means this angle and this angle, we have to prove it same. Then what we can say, if this and this angle are same, if this and this angle are same, then what we can say, that this thing will be parallel to this thing. Okay, so now we don't know it, but we have to prove that. To prove AD parallels BC, we have to prove that angle DBC equals to angle ADB. So let's write it here. We will write angle ADB equals to angle DBC. In the bracket we are going to write. What we are going to write? The same line as here it is written, but instead of this we have alternative way. We can write CPCT. We can write CPCT, which is the alternative way. Or instead we can write that as this thing, another thing can happen, that as this all happens, so CPCT, that means CPCT only. So after proving this, we can write this. So angle ADB equals to angle DBC, which is CBC. Okay, so this thing has been proved. Dot dot dot. So this thing has been proved. Our fifth theorem has been done. So meeting you in the next video. For that time, be safe and thank you.